Want to create a freeze frame? We all do, of course. Why? Who wouldn't? Well, let's learn more on how to do that all within Final Cut Pro right now. Here, we have a clip of a sea turtle. Let's review this clip from the beginning. Look at this little fish trying to photobomb. We'll freeze some frames of him to give him the spotlight. Let's drag the playhead backwards, then press space on your keyboard to play the clip. Once we see the best frame to pause, hit the space bar again. With your playhead paused on the frame, navigate up to Edit and add freeze frame, or use the shortcut Option F. Now we have a still image of the frame we chose. We can shorten or extend the duration as much as we need by dragging on this handle. You can put the freeze frame tool to good use by creating sequences of frames. Every freeze frame can be scaled and zoomed in. You can even apply different effects to each one. Here's an example of freeze frames in action. Drum roll, please. We know you're excited to make your own freeze frames, but before you do, here's some additional tips. You can also add a freeze frame from a browser clip. Click to select the frame in the clip you want. Then go up to Edit and Connect Freeze Frame, or use the shortcut Option F. This will connect the frame to wherever your playhead is on the timeline. Whenever you create a freeze frame, it will be the default duration for still images set in your preferences. If you need to change this, navigate up to Final Cut Pro and Preferences. This window will appear in the center of the screen. Make sure you're on the Editing tab and change the still image duration using the up and down arrows. And that's how you create freeze frames in Final Cut Pro. Don't forget to check out the Pixel Film Studio store, where you can find a bunch of Final Cut plugins designed to take your project to the next level. If you want to be an awesome Final Cut editor, all you gotta do is like and share.